It's the
Shirt is super awesome. Are you talking about the shirt I'm wearing or the shirt that I've got for sale? I want to show that off. The fucking Puma shirt. Yeah, it's pretty sweet. Some folks from Teespring contacted me and were like, yo, how do you feel about if we made you like some specific reference to your stream, put it on a t-shirt, some high quality printing. Had it branded. And I was like, hell yeah. We went through a bunch of different formats for like how the shirt could look. We had the stream like vote on like the placement of the CalebDMTG logo. Big for a sec. Show off this hoodie. Yes! 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 Yeah. Yep. It was good. Some high quality stuff. Got that pocket in the front. The t-shirt also has the Puma logo. But it's on the side, it's on the sleeve there, you see. Yeah, when we settled on Puma to be the brand, and I started thinking about what kind of cross thing we could do. I had a vile deck turn out okay earlier. It's kind of a sweet one. I wonder if Pack One Pick One Avenger can get me there. I haven't really had a ramp deck payoff yet in this cube. Black Sun Zenith might be nice. It's been good for my opponents. The issue with Black Sun Zenith is if you end up going in a more aggressive direction, which you usually want to do in this format, then it can play out weirdly. Blood Chiefs might even be a more important card. Really efficient removal is so important. Yeah. Well, this pack is less exciting, isn't it? Do I have a stip in me? Shit, I didn't see your comment. I would love to do a stip, but I'm already like a pick or two in. Maybe I can make the Artifact Matters deck work. I haven't seen it really pop off yet. This is not the modern cube, this is the Proliferate cube. Created by one Emma Handy. Yeah, I'm not 100%. Maybe Wheel of Thopterist. Not 100% that I'll do another full cube after this. Usually I go till around 2 in the morning, but I had a very early start on the stream today. We'll see where my energy level's at. I'll get some more caffeine in me, get some more water. Oh man, I think I'm gonna take a bath tonight. Take a good, nice long soak. Are they tight enough that you should order a size up? I don't think so. Give me a second here. Just to spit out Thopters. Servos. Huh. There's Emery here too. Let's grab Emery. I think they're sized pretty appropriately. They're like Puma's regular sizes. So like this one was a little tight on me, and it is... Oh, this is a regular extra large. Not even a double. Not even a double. Yeah, I'm surprised I got this on. I'm surprised I got it on. Usually I wear triple X and they're like nice and comfy on me. They're like nice and loose. That t-shirt I put on is just like a normal large and it was tight on me. But usually if I'm going to go a size down, I stop at 2X. So ordering for your regular size should be totally fine. Should be absolutely appropriate. The Unhinged thinks the sub is a 20 month there. Ooh, Ginger Brute. Hell yeah. What does this even do?
Oh shit, what up?
Double the number of counters, or each kind of counter on a number of target permanents. That's kind of sweet.
Oh shit, what up?
Hey, Rice J Rod thinks the sub thinks the 15 months. And Wild Sizzle thinks the sub thinks the 36 months there, the 3 years. Fuck yeah. Oh, okay, you've got some very specific answers to the question. Someone said the Puma in general runs about 2% smaller than expected fit. Good to know, good to know. How am I liking the cube? I've been enjoying the cube. A lot of interesting synergies. I found that you're usually better off applying pressure in this cube. Go mono blue, grab the Spire Golem. Probably not. Psionic Blast seems decent. Fits the bill on that removal stuff that I want. Hopefully will the signal pass? Maybe. Once you get to a certain spot, like, the odds of wheeling something go down tremendously, right? Because at a certain point, people are just, like, goofing picks because there's nothing left in the pack. Hey, Ego Fiend. Thanks for the 200 bits. Yeah. Not keen on any of these cards. I guess Cryptologist is kind of cute with Emery. They did make Char in blue, yeah. I've cast that card in Legacy before. And I'm willing to admit it on stream. Hope I don't have to play Sickle Slicer. The blue-red artifact cards aren't wheeling. It's a bad sign. I'm kind of all in, right, with my picks. There's some blue-red Thopter Makers that I was hoping were going to come back. Sure, probably not unanimous. Thanks for chiming in. I appreciate that. Obviously don't know very much, right? I've got a little place down by the sea. It ain't much, but it's enough for me. I like Empowered Auto-Generate a lot. It just doesn't seem like the deck for it. Horse apples? Aww. The one thing I don't like about this new UI is like the placement of the sideboard. And now I can like hang out there longer than I like sometimes. We are playing black, then Parting Thoughts is really high pickup, but I think the way that our deck is looking, Hangerback Walker seems pretty important. Really good chance we just cut black too for red at some point. Or be mono blue artifacts, that would also be fine. Right now we want a plating pretty bad. We want that Ornithopter to wheel. We want a lot of stuff. And we're fighting. And we're fighting someone in blue-red artifacts. It ain't much, but it's enough for Blockhand is interesting. I don't hate serrated arrows as well. If we end up proliferating, the arrows start to look good. Does this die when it's empty? Arrows? Yeah. That's kind of cool with Emery. Okay, so this is between Riftwing, Spark Double, Ink Moth, or Untethered Express. Express might be good. I haven't seen it be good yet in this queue, but it might be good. Unlicensed is like slightly not in our colors. I kinda like the Ink Moth. I want to take the Ink Moth. Memnite, Aether Spell Bomb. Flare Husk. Lesser. We'll take the Spell Bomb. It disappears so well with Emery. Really nice pickup. Yeah, the Ink Moth art is dope. I definitely want to play that. Yeah, I was thinking that we were going to cut black, but none of these Baleful Strix. And then here came Baleful Strix, floating around the old table. Metallic Rebuke would also be good, but I think we want the Strix. Yeah, I like that Eternal Witness a lot too, Disco Shark. That whole set's dope. I think the people that designed the cube picked the arts for them, Wolf. Baleful Strix is nice. Anytime you pick up a card that's like actually playable, just like actually constructed playable, it's always a good sign. Crypolith doesn't do anything here, right? Just a mana rock. Each player has 10 life or less, it flips. Then you get like a weird death touch thing. You lose your artifact. I kinda want Hexmage. I might grab a Hexmage. Cletus is kinda interesting too. The double black on Hexmage is the only troubling thing, but I guess it's also an issue with the other one. Be a real nice engine deck. Yeah, designing a cube seems like a ton of work. Folks have asked me if that's something that I'd be interested in a few times, and every time I'm just like, I think I'd rather play someone else's cube. I think I'd enjoy that more. Victimize is almost interesting with like Emery and Baleful Strix. A lot of our creatures sack themselves. Scarecrow's a little awkward, the rest of the deck. Just taking the blue flyer might have been fine. Hey, you want a Thopter Wield? Awesome, I'll draft it. Commit to Memory also would have been fine. We're having some efficient artifacts though. Yeah, if I was going to put together a cube in paper and Treebeard at the end, it'd be a lot like that, I think. It'd either be like cards that I like, or I'd just like print out the vintage cube. Awesome. I'm excited by Disciple or Dockhand. I think I'd take the Dockhand. The more cheap artifacts we have, the better Emery is. I think the better our deck is. my reasoning there. Dockhand isn't amazing, though. It's not the best card ever. Mimnite versus Flare Husk. Nice, the Rebuke came back. It's a really nice Rebuke deck. True, I do not have all the power. I think if I sold all of my magic art and all of my artist proofs and all of my cards, I think I would still be short a set of power. Power's pretty fucking expensive. Soul Diviner good here? I like the prism. We saw the Baleful Strix like kinda late. It's possible the Diviner just comes back anyway. In my house, yeah. House could probably buy some power. Well, the Live the Dream Cube, I don't think I would print it out. I think I would just build it. I think the only reason that I would print out the Vintage Cube to play with friends is because power is so prohibitive. I can't even remember if the Living the Dream Cube like uses original duels or whatever. That Sunken Ruins wheels. This is like my third time getting Marionette Master, and this is also gonna be like my third time never drawing it or seeing it. Get Tar Pit up in this. Phyrexian Scriptures is good, but it's not good in every matchup, right? Tar Pit's always gonna be good. Blade is interesting. I want this guide, huh? Collector's Edition power. Yeah, I mean, it's like already dealing with proxies, right? Crane seems dope. I think I'm gonna draft the Water Grave, though. I have a... a set of artist proof power. Just a set of moxes. I think it was Dan Frazier that did the originals. So I don't have like a Lotus. I guess I'm supposed to draft this thing. Lotus or Time Walker Recall. A Time Walk proxy would be pretty easy to grab, though, with the artist proof method. Amy Weber's wonderful. I'm very open to commissions and such. Right, Scooger? Yeah, if I do the trouble of putting a cube together, I want to actually be able to play with it without being paranoid. Which means it's either gonna be like a peasant cube or it's gonna involve some proxies for really expensive cards. And then, of course, it's different if you're just, like, playing with friends. Yeah, that makes sense, Death Coach. Nice backwards ghost. Great choice. I think the Essence Scatter might be coming out. Peasant Cube is fun. Peasant Cube is super fun. For some reason, it feels like Peasant Cube is harder to actually like fill a group. Considering the Paradise Mantle. Versus like Dusk Urchins or something. Really, Whisper Me? Jeez. What kind of EDH folk are you playing with? Walker, Swooper, and Strix all make sense. How many black permanents do we have for Strix? Like two? Yeah, maybe that makes less sense. Let me take the Swooper. Maybe I'll take Walker. I'll draft the Walker. We just don't have the equipment to make it actually good. More zero mana artifacts might be nice. Yeah, I don't think we quite got there for this deck. I think we got close, but not quite there. We're missing like the 2-mana 1/1, the taps to put a 1/1 counter on all your artifacts. We're missing Arcbound Ravager, we're missing Plating. We were definitely fighting somebody. They might have moved off of it after the first pack, but still hurt us a lot. Should maybe be playing Coils. I knew it can load it up. These cards all kind of make sense. Yeah, Plating would have been insane. With Tar Pit and Ink Moth, Plating would have been nuts in this deck. I think the Essence Scatter is coming out. I think we kind of need to have to play the Sickle Slicer, even though I'm super not pleased about it. And then maybe Rift Wing comes out too. Maybe I cut the Swooper. I think the Sphinx is actually kind of good. We could cut it, but it is value. So you play it like rebuy like Prophetic Prism or Strix or what have you. Set your Sickle Slicer. It's probably supposed to be a cut. And then I think we got a 16 lane deck here. Not 15, right? I Hexmage could start in the sideboard. Hexmage is just good against everybody, though. It's been my experience. Maybe far and away is better to start in the board. Keep the Swooper in. Perfect. Is that perfect? Or do we want one more blue source? Right now it's 9-9. Could be 10-8. I think 9-9's fine. We mostly just need like a single blue source for the most part. Alright, this is my second time trying to make artifact nonsense work. I'm excited. I think if this deck wins or loses, a lot's gonna depend on, you know, if we actually get our payoffs, right? Like if we get a fast Emery or fast Zahid, or if we actually like draw Marionette Master and it gets to do its sweet, sweet thing. That champion can win games too. That champion certainly won plenty of games off of that card and that card alone. Hopefully I don't destroy my keyboard tonight.
Oh shit, what up?
This hand seems reasonable. Hey Fire Tank, thanks for the sub, thanks for the 18 months. Glad you appreciate the old streamerino. I'll keep going as long as people keep watching, huh? Keep doing my best. Thanks to the bits, Kane. You got some NSP? You got some NSP for us? Oh, yeah. We started the stream with this track. I thought it was pretty dope. Close your eyes. You're like an angel in the morning light. While you're dreaming, a new day waits for you. Oh shit, what up? Hey, Yuka Chaka, thanks to the sub, thanks to 37 months. So now we can activate Hanger Bank, or we can Metallic Rebuke something. We can't do both. Well, it's probably worth rebuking. Alright.
I see you're still awake for some reason. Was it the guitar solo? Was it the demons? Yeah, people have told us that before. Little
child. Next turn we can blast the Sage and level up Hanger Bank. The gentle sex lull us all to sleep. I think I'd take another two.
Apparently, lots of venomous snakes can open doors. But now, check out my airport!
like specific counters, right? Arrowhead counters. Edge champion being pro all colors is pretty messed up. Pretty good.
Good night.
Yeah, the new album's pretty rockin', huh? NSP's been on a tear lately. Been on a fucking tear. Oh yeah, Shinny. Yeah, I kind of miss artifact aggro being a thing too. It was kind of just like hanging on when Opal got banned.
Please infuse my nuts with the power of 1,000 suns.
See.
Holy shit,
for him. Spinning the counters around so that double proliferate is pretty gnarly. It's already pretty gnarly.
Hello, my name is Dan. And that's Brian, and we are Ninja Sex Party.
Hi.
We wrote the song that we are the most proud of in our entire careers. It's a 12-minute long song about wizards and adventures called The Mystic Crystal. And we wanted to make this insane video for it. This will actually be our 50th music video when it comes out. And for all the other
music ass load of music videos.
Done, totally out of pocket. We paid for it ourselves.
Especially these days.
One, it's so big and so insane that we just can't afford it.
Yeah.
So we wanted to do a little fundraiser if you guys are down. And that's why we created these sweet NSP Superfan pins.
What? Look at this, Tucker. Can you
You see that right there?
Get I definitely have one of these pins.
Oh, they're so limited edition.
Okay. Yeah, so we didn't want to just sweet. Come to you guys and just say, hey, give
I don't know if they're still on sale, though.
Yeah, that doesn't, like the idea doesn't feel right.
So what we decided instead was we made these limited edition pins. They're $20 each, and we have a very limited number of them.
I'm just going to crack them, crack in for twice with the Pro All Colors.
That, the money from that will go directly into making the video we want to make for this thing, which is, do you want to tell them a little bit about the video?
Yeah, sure.
Are you missing something? No, I just forgot.
We're going to go into this video.
It was part of the plan. Proliferating the Gnarland was part of the plan.
The Knights of the Light Table, who did Starlight Raid.
Yeah, they're amazing.
And lots of fun guest stars. And
punt?
All kinds
yeah.
of cool stuff.
Huge punt.
Never been able to pull
I'm not sure we'll be able to recover.
And it's, dare I say, batshit crazy?
It's batshit crazy, but the song is worth it. Like, as Danny said, we are the most proud of this song, of any song we've ever written in our entire careers. Like, the song is totally done. We have the final audio. And in fact,
we're going to play it for you right now.
Yep, so you can hear it and decide if you want to support us on this. I think you're going to like it. That's fair to say, right?
Yeah,
I think you're
going
to like it. You may even love it. So it's right at the end of this video. It's also out on Spotify today, so you can check it out there. But check it out. The link for the pin will be, we'll put it in the description. We'll have it on our social media, all those places. Oh, there it is. Look, is that on?
Look how good it looks on a lapel.
Wow.
This is my lapel, right? The,
yeah.
Whatever.
Sure.
I didn't put it on.
Oh, there it is. Bam. Right there.
Ba-do-boop-boop-doop.
So everything.
Oh, shit. What up?
Hey, C3 Football, thanks to the sub, thanks to the 30 months. I kind of like the idea of playing the Djinn of Wishes. Just having like a giant flyer seems pretty good against them. The issue, though, is that it has to like replace like Far Away or something. Counter's a little bit worse on the draw, too. Their whole deck seemed like it was, like, creature-based, though. X-Mage looked dope. Yeah, let's just do this. If I'd waited on using arrows, could have gotten more arrow counters. I could have, yeah. I wanted to make sure that the Tyler's Tracker was off the board, though. That's not one you wanted to just, like, let your opponent have. They crack a clue, and then the tracker like already removes the first neg one counter. And now the Proliferate doesn't do anything. They crack another one, then they get ahead of it. Great. Use the last counter to kill a Jade Light, sure. I mean, we were at like 10 or something, right? I wasn't blocking. I didn't want to block with my 1-1. Because we were spreading the 1-1 counters around. That was the other option. If I didn't want to go down to like 8 life or whatever it was to trade the 1-1 for the 2-1. But that seemed poor. And Baleful Strix. Baleful Strix is like single-handedly making this hand look good. Sorry, sometimes when I think about like the rest of the game, like I'm trying to focus on the moment and win at that spot, and then I go into sideboarding and then I'm like thinking about the next game. It's not crazy to forget my reasoning for some play decision however long ago. Just kill that fucking thing immediately.
Hey Ninja Brian.
Does the Caleb D hoodie run large? I thought that they were about normal. Someone was telling me, someone who sounded like a real shirt printing expert was saying that the Puma tends to run 2% tight, 2% less than expected fit. So not uber tight, but if you're between two sizes, maybe imp or larger.
Rose the king, so gross and old. I've called you from the great beyond to save my daughter, hot and blonde. Sailed across the sky and stars. The gods have brought you here unharmed. Actually, Your Majesty, you just sucked us through 26 dimensions of space.
This literally does nothing right now.
I'm completely honest with you. My arms are broken, and I don't know why my chest is smoking. I will heal you with my staff. I'm sure we'll look back on this and laugh. Now go, ride toward the sun and top these noble steeds.
Great. Is this like the worst contagion engine of all time? Might be close. Just like activating Bastion. I wonder why they didn't do it on their turn. I guess that's why. Hey, congrats, Kane. Way to fucking vote. Ryan brought his magic arrows. They were blessed to light our righteous way. Alright. So yeah, the Strix was a really good draw, but it didn't quite do enough. We needed like an Emery to bring it back, or Spellbomb or something.
You're about to light our righteous way?
Trample.
Oh, God! Alright, fine. Whatever, man. Let's run!
It's almost interesting.
The trees were twisted and the air was thick. It was clear his domain was as evil as Dick. We passed through the gloom of the fires to fear.
Yeah, Jim would have been good there. I'm not sure what I'm supposed to cut though. Regina Wishes. I don't like cutting any of this stuff. Yeah, the Ruination Guide. Guide seems really strong with, like, I don't know, my artifacts. My shitty artifact creatures. Maybe this is, like, not what we're doing in this matchup, though.
I know, it's weird. We arrived at the
evil woods hall and dismounted our trusty steed. Oh my god. If we draw like any artifact before turn 4 Zahid, turn 5 Jhin, is actually really strong. The issue is we don't have anything like that now. Let's do a quick count. And bring up the deck list. I think turn 4 Zahid is actually good. God, stream deck is just slow. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6 with Baleful Strix. I'm gonna count Demery. 7, 8.
Colored gemstones lit up.
9, 10, 11, 12, 13. They formed a rainbow. So like 13-ish artifacts, and then like a couple of other plays. With 3 draws.
And there the necromancer.
I think this is okay.
Princess stood frozen, yet still so hot.
I think we're like roughly around 16 live draws.
Then I heard
to make this hand good. There we go. Hello, best draw possible into the second best draw. Yeah, we kind of built around Emery pretty hard. I don't quite want to trade. They might not want to trade either if I'm holding back the Strix, but I don't play this heat next turn. What's up, Lou? Not bad, not a bad primal mind. Good keep, yeah, right? If we hadn't drawn well, then like it would have been like a terrible keep and everyone would be calling me an idiot. But we hit, so. I'm gonna take four. Hey, that's fine. Oh, it might not even be four, right? They might not be serving the Strix here. Three is 12. Oh man, maybe Strix should have served. I didn't do the math, but if we deal one more damage last turn, then it'll be 13. And we could actually have Xaxes here, right? We can have Xaxes with the tar pit. Kind of forgot I had a tar pit there. Oh well, I think we're probably okay.
Seems that our journey is at an end. We will be here if you should ever need.
All right, soggy Cheerios. Time to sog down.
We walked away, but stopped in 10 before we took our last step. Brian killed a guy.
Yeah, you think this looks good? I wasn't sure. Wasn't sure if we had a good one or not.
We all have our battles to fight, and a crystal cage to break through in our lives. But when hope is gone, we will be there to help you rock the fort.
For some reason in my head, and I keep thinking this is port, it's not port at all. Well, that draw worked out. We had a pretty good chance of drawing the, or having the Djinn on turn four, but we drew even better than that. Hell yeah, Duffy. Hell yeah. His Mandel looks really bad in this hand. If it was letting me turn to an Emery or something, pretty decent. Not the situation, though. Gotta equip the Mantle there, so we have a chance of misclicking.
Oh,
don't know. We can serve a Charpit and Thopter, hit him down to 16, and they like attack, roll the Cranko, make some 1-1s. We clear the 1-1s, but then the Cranko would just be a 1-2 again and like ready to attack again. I don't know if that's good. The issue with going for the Charpit trade is if they have another burn spell, then we're just in a really rough spot, right? And then we're not even like fogging them through the engine. We're just getting run over. Too bad we're not playing the engine this turn, huh? Let's see. You were told there was cheese. Who spread such lies and slander? Oh, that was me. I'll just send you to HR. Awesome. Well, I'm glad that worked. The cheese in cube form? Oh no, we don't do that here. It's not that kind of place. You don't get to pick your shapes. Except shark fists. Whoever gets cheese and crackers, then eat them separately. Like step one. Step one, we eat cheese. Alright, now we're all out of cheese. Time to eat some crackers. Is that what you're talking about? You sick fuck. Can you imagine get one of those like fancy meat and cheese boards with like the little bits of like jam and stuff, like all the like awesome, all the awesome nonsense, and then you eat them all like one at a time. Like step one, I eat all the crackers. Step two, I eat all of this type of cheese. Step two, I like scrape the dipping jelly up. The servers are just like, what a goddamn monster. Cheese has to go first. You have an order? You have an order to it all? I wonder if we should be playing our Kazmina just for the double proliferate. Charcuterie. Cha. Is that not how it's supposed to happen? I don't think so. I always take a cracker, dip a little bit in the jam. And all the dippins. Get a little bit of cheese with the crackers. That's so good. Get that mixture of flavors. Move around the board and try a little bit of everything. Eating just like all of one type of meat and then like eating all of the crackers, these dry crackers, and then like eating all of another type of cheese. Oh, this seems like a waste. Adult Lunchables, yeah. Really, probably? They were like, what? It's just meat and cheese on a board. This is shit. It's funny. What does this do when they hit me? Oh, I don't want that. I'm against that specifically happening. Does champion do anything? Kind of. Oh, I just saw Pat Daddy's resub. They said, hey, I've been trying to make a Kenrith deck work with white and mana artifacts. Are there any good examples? Not off the top of my head. Sometimes days pass and this emptiness fills my heart when I want to. Give me it so the Gadrak doesn't spit out some more treasures here. Letting them die on my turn. We also begin an infect counter on them. And then Contagion could just, like, be my win con. So much waste. I don't think that's quite happening this game, though. And this moment keeps slipping away. If I was firing my Thopter, does that matter? So hard, oh, they're putting a 1-1 counter on Spirit Dragon. That's what they're doing. Fuck. I can't counter that. Ugh. God, that's so good. To keep me awake and alive. Seems like a miserable metallic rebuke. All my instincts, they return. And the grand facade. So this is just giving us a chump next turn. Without a noise, without my pride, I reach brutal stuff. Right, I mean, that's why I blocked Tribute of the Ent. It'd be hard to get the Ink Moth around the Gadget clone. I see the doorways to a thousand churches. The resolution of all my fruitless searches. Oh, I see the light and the heat. Oh, I wanna be that complete. I wanna touch the light, the heat. Man, we're just like holding Mag Champion to keep the wizard from smacking me. Bummer, huh? Are there cheese-related magic cards? You better believe there are. The best magic card ever printed is cheese-related. It's called The Cheese Stands Alone. Control no cards in play other than the cheese stands alone and have no cards in your hand. You win the game. You win the game! The game. They just lose! I will touch this. And you don't even need cards in hand or anything. Till I know I'm home again. That's interesting. These are wish counters, though. Pro Blue Rain, yeah, Pro Wayne Bloom. Do we attack with the Edge Champion here? They just move the sword to the wizard. Right? Oh, but then I'd be able to block the Doran. Yeah, I guess Champion should have served. Getting to be a bit much. Sure, Redbird Grad. For sure. A couple options here. How large is this thing? It's a 5/5. I think I block it. I probably have some sick spell to blow this out. Put a line to line. Play my land first. Oh hey, how about that? Kind of does something.
What up?
Shrink here. Let's see. It goes from 4 to 6. Yes, I'd rather shrink that than kill the wizard. We can kill the wizard right now.
Thank you so much for watching our music video. If you liked what you saw, like, comment, and subscribe right here.
Okay, might as well do this now then.
If you liked what you heard, buy our music. Ooh. Also, don't forget to check out our good friends Ninja Sex Party. Bah! And Laser Horse. Ooh.
Oh, growing the arrows was wrong. Should have left it. Where it was, maybe. I kind of wanted to die.
Somewhere, deep in the slow eternal dance of the heavens, drifts a planet called simply Earth. And among the otherwise unremarkable population of this planet are two incredible heroes, destined to save the future from itself!
Well, they got this turn.
Machine spaceship. You want to go on it? Yeah. Okay, cool. Computer. Set a sexy course for the sexy.
Yes, we have arrows for Memnite. I'm just gonna say that because it's an instant speed win, and they don't have a win on board. Let's untap, do the plan, which was Contagion Engine for the last 7. And then if they have a burn spell for me or something, I can like arrows for the win instead. Sexy at all.
I can't believe my eyes, but it's a world without sex. Everyone here.
Kazmina would be doing like some crazy shit with Contagion Engine. The issue is like, what do we cut, right? What do we cut for it? Maybe the Psionic Blast in this matchup isn't that good. The dragon's like a 6-5 or whatever. Will it come back? Yeah. Yeah, I was a little worried there in the middle game because Contagion Engine just wasn't doing anything. But the Djinn of Wishes, oh man, the Marionette Master and the everything kind of came together at the last minute. The Gingerbrood life gain, everything. Just being able to sack Gingerbrood is pretty important. Song's wild. It is wild. You're not wrong. It's a fucking ride.
Shoot the fucking light.
go turn one spell bomb, turn two in soul, and just like smack in.
Ninja Brian,
I think getting the walker down.
With sad eyes and the beautiful blonde hair, I'm immediately in love.
She's pretty decent. I'm worried about just like making a 5/5 and then just pointing the 5 damage spell, the 3 mana deal 5. Not bad. We can play a second land. I guess like any burn spell does it, huh? If we insole artifact something. Maybe just correct. Maybe just correct anyway. We'd also go like power conduit, spell bomb, and then next turn champion. The issue with champion is we can't insole it very well. Let me just do this. Stormblood has a menace, so I'm not going to be blocking that. That fucking sucks. Yeah. Do I remember when Affinity could play 3 drops? Oh yeah. I remember when Affinity was playable. I remember when people could play that at all, right?
Darling, I will always love you. What is your name, by the way? Kristen?
It's a bad attack with a contingent engine in hand.
Until that
fine.
Glorious day when we meet again, Katie. Farewell.
Awkward. So awkward. I think you still cast it, right? The contagion. Yeah, right, Leobold? Born out for the Bald Scourge. I don't know, what do y'all think? What if we target ourselves with Contagion Engine? I wish we could target both players. Yeah, that's the plan, Red 7.
Fuck yeah.
That's the plan here.
Fuck yeah.
Oh, they can't target the champion. I was like, maybe they'll keep me proliferate. Maybe they'll help me out here. Perilous Mirage still gets to like block and hit me. Maybe should have still hit them with the contagion, huh?
Oh shit, what up?
Can't even like activate Tar Pit and Proliferate. Hell yeah, Luck Dragon. The 22-month sub, almost 2 years, seems like the story is never ending. Yeah, is that what it seems like? I'm about to play for you the most rancid cover.
Oh shit, what up?
Hey Lord Bergie, thanks for the sub, it's 8 months. Can't block the minister, of course. This Perilous Mirror is fucking harshing my salad. What is this, kale? Hey Nogwig, thanks to the sub, thanks to the 16 months. Kazmina. I don't think Psionic Blast would have won there either, but I drew you and lost, so I get to blame you. I'm a Luck Dragon. God, that dragon looks so weird. Like 90% dog, 10% dragon. And not like the cool, like fire breathing part of the dragon. Like has weird scales in the middle of its fur part of the dragon. Such good, strong hands. That's a sweet moment. The rock giant just being so sad because his friends were sucked into the nothing. They couldn't hold on to them. They look like such good, strong hands, don't they? The movie's got some delicious weirdness about it. Feels like every scene. Some awesome weird nonsense is happening. Oh man. Well, so long as we get Zahid Dan on 4, I'll be happy. I run out this Memnite? I guess I do. The chance I want to give it a soul next turn. The book is much weirder. Oh, nice. Why have I not read that? Is Malira the anti-me sideboard card? Sure makes this fucking serrated arrows look bad, right? you liked part two? I don't believe you. I just straight up don't believe you. We didn't sell the artifact and soul artifact on the Sword of Truth. They wouldn't be able to equip. Not sure if I should Emery or Hexmage on turn two. Or am I not sorry, not turn two, but second main phase. You thought part two was great? Yeah, you're definitely messing with me. I'm not even close to believing you. Why not tap the sickle slicer? Oh, the equipment? Sure. Instead of the Memnite. Well, that's a huge fucking bummer, isn't it? I should equip the mantle to the Emery. Gonna kill the Memnite, and then they put the sword on the Dorat, and then they've got like a pro blue thing to block the Zahid here. That's what I was expecting anyway. That's pretty strong. Mana short. Vevin lethal. Let's just do this then. You think of cold beer cane? I don't know. Don't play that one as much. Productive turn. Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, this game turned into a fucking grind, didn't it? Turned into the old miserable slog. God, I'm only at 5 minutes. Should probably play faster, huh? Pro Blue. It looks like they're gonna get a sword hit in. And maybe turn on the Gadrak. Fuck. We power conduit the counter from the Emery to make sure they trade. I don't know if I want to trade, because then the Gadrak just gets turned on. I think this is actually better. It's awkward, but... Fuck. That's gonna get turned on anyway. And they keep the wizard. Looking rough, folks. Looking rough. Maybe I shouldn't have blocked. Maybe I should just let the sword hit me. Silent Blast off the top. Yeah, we do have that one in. Far and Away would be dope. I think. Yeah, it'd be dope. I don't think that does anything. Unfortunate. Yeah, I got them to three. Between like the power conduit and the serrated arrows, it seems like there should have been some way that we could have like the Memnite and the Emery both repping lethal. Maybe I like prioritize blocking the sorted up wizard too highly. The next card. The next card, Aether Spellbomb, and into Baleful Strix. Not that Strix is amazing on that board, but yeah, that's been my issue with these artifact decks, is that like they're not quite consistent enough with the draws. I always feel like I'm missing a piece. That was almost a good Emery game. We got some value, but it was like medium value, right? No shame in losing to that dragon card. That card's really strong. Ensoul off the top here. I don't think we need Ensoul. I think our draw's just good. And Soul kind of makes you weak to some strategies, right? Like, you have a 5-5, you have a really efficient 5-5. The opponent's just like, yeah, kill your thing. And you just feel silly. Just get 2-for-1 down the wazoo. This is the last round, right? Yeah. It's like 11. Usually I go to like 2, but I started some hours early today.
Oh shit, what up?
Gotcha, Robbot. Yeah, about my usual length of stream. I think I got another cube in me, though. I think I got one more. Hey, Tecalm, thanks for the sub. Thanks for sharing the Prime. Appreciate it. I'm a Sickle Slicer here. And maybe start with the Ginger Brute. Yeah, let's do that. Bigger stuff. Well, I don't think it has anything to do with the bigger stuff. I think it's a matter of like having your draws be consistent and come together as consistently as the draws are for the other decks. And being able to fit in like enough removal. I think removal is really important in this format. The bigger stuff's awesome. The heat is awesome. Fucking Marionette Master's gas. Cranial Plating's gas. Ravager is still good. Tempting to, like, just far bounce the hero and run out of Walker on one. Smack in for three. It's a little weak to them having a removal spell for Zahid. But Zahid, though, like, if it's going to be a removal spell, it's not going to be, like, a burn spell, right? And six is a lot of toughness. Got you, Robbot. You're saying that you might, that like, you think the artifact deck should be built with like a super tight curve, like Modern Affinity or whatever. I think it's really hard to consistently have enough playables, though, with a deck like that. Both times I've drafted the deck, I haven't quite gotten there. I've had like half of a affinity deck, and I've had to stretch into other directions a little bit. This deck is pretty close. This deck's about as close as I've gotten, but some of the artifact filler cards have been pretty bad. This is far and away. Tempting to bounce the vampire, but just getting the hero off the board lets us get a little zesty here. And then depending on how they sacrifice, we might attack differently. Yeah, we're playing Sickle Slicer just to have enough artifacts, just to have enough stuff. When I was drafting the deck, I was like, hopefully I don't have to play this fucking thing. Yeah, you hope to not have to play a card like that, and then when you have to play it, you hope not to draw it. Okay, that's pretty bad. At least it's not exiling my Hangerback Walker, I suppose. Now I can replay a hero next turn. Do have a few pieces of removal. The Fairgrounds Warden, we have a couple. How's everyone doing tonight? Everyone having a pleasant evening? This feels way too early for chat to be dead.
Shit, what up?
Any of y'all lurkers gonna keep me company? Hey, Hyperfencer, thanks for the sub, thanks for the 36 months, the 3 years. You're great? That's awesome to hear. I'm Deez. I didn't do as much winning as I wanted to today, but that's like pretty small complaint in the greater picture of things, right? You have the winning days, and you have the days where you do the other thing. Dead, not sleeping. You're in another chat arguing about politics. That sounds like a super useful, super, super great use of your time there. You're miserable? Ah, I'm sorry, Roscoe. A lot of folks are dead. Long week dead. Been a long week. Yeah. Well, it's fucking Friday, huh? Yeah. I shouldn't be prodding folks. Everyone's all tuckered out. End of a long work week. And then this asshole streamer's like, oh, why is nobody talking to me? Yeah. Grinch is having a good one. Good to hear. Good to hear. Hodge is building a new cube. That's sweet. What's this activate again? I wonder if I should be attacking. If you attack for 8 here, what do they do? What do they fucking do? I'm still like paranoid of hero killing me, but maybe hero attack's fine. What is my favorite card this cube? The cards that like are just like way better than in usual cubes have been the ones that I've been enjoying the most. Where you have to like you have to switch up your card evaluation. Cards like Vampire Hexmage that just like super overperform in Encounters Matter cube. Those have been the most fun, I think. What's my favorite deck that I've seen or played so far? I drafted a really sweet Mono Black Sacrifice deck that I threw up on Twitter. That deck did really well. That was probably my favorite. Hey, Todd Draconis, thanks for the sub. Thanks for the 31 months there. Did I get Hyperfencer sub? Yeah, the 3 years. Yeah, I got that. Oh, that fucking sucks. Yeah, right, Raptor. Ah, well. So we move the slicer over a tank. They have to block with Fairgrounds Warden. Our 5/6 comes back into play. Now we have two lethal threats. They have one card in hand. Even if they like draw a good one, Hero Blade holds jumping next turn. I don't blame them for scooping there. The attack for 8 worked out. It did, yeah. I realized I was just being too passive, maybe. Or maybe that was the first turn where attacking was, like, truly good. Just thinking these cards might be strong. Just cut, like, this fucking talk hand. Maybe cut Sickle Slicer. Psionic looks awesome. Maybe cut Metallic Rebuke on the draw. I don't know, it's a really good rebuke deck. Let's actually cut the Hexmage. Yeah, I like that. Hey, good luck, guard yourself. Good fucking luck. Saw your comment. This song has a really nice groove to it. Nice plucking, steady plucking, just going through the whole thing. It's a real nice energy. Tricky turn. I think you just run out Strix. And then if the answer is Strix, they're at least not growing their Figure of Destiny. The other line is to run out Hangerback Walker or hold up Essence Scatter. I think holding up Essence Scatter is kind of bad. Maybe they just like activate and serve. I guess that's pretty bad if we have a removal spell. Still kind of like this. Oh, I didn't slow my F6 in time to get the Ornithopter down. Oh, thanks, Thresh Captain. Perfect. That is exactly how I wanted that turn to go. Did we see a third color last game? I don't think we did. The keyboard? I'm not sure yet. Some people advise me to run it through the dishwasher first before plugging it back in. I think I'm gonna do that. Run it through the dishwasher, let it dry out for a few days, and then try it. Right now I'm using my backup keyboard. The last time I lost a keyboard to situations entirely outside of my control. The last time I lost a keyboard to variance, I bought two. Because I have, like, the exact fucking keyboard that I like. Like, it perfectly fits my keyboard tray. The switches are... Anyway. So I have a backup. I had a spare. The other one's resting now. Well, that seems strong. Does it take away flying? It doesn't look like it. What did I spill? Spilled some beer. Spilled like my literal last sip of beer on my keyboard last night. If you want to see how that played out, you can watch the tail end of the VOD. And I recommend turning down your earphones. Hell yeah, Skogan. That we're holding up something because the Nexus isn't hitting in for an infect. I think that's correct, though. So many colors. Yeah, I better hit the Ornithopter. Because they hit the Insole artifact. We still have the O2 chilling, hanging out. You tried the dishwasher advice with your laptop keyboard, didn't go so well. Interesting. Interesting. Did it not go well because it was a laptop keyboard? Or do you not think it would go well for anyone? Man, this plan of holding up Essence Scatter is not going so well, is it?
Oh shit, what up?
This might be wrong. Yeah. I still think I'm holding up Scatter, so I should have just played Walker for one. Hey, Zooby Zoo. Thanks for the sub. Thanks for 21 months. One's deck's playing out very different from last game. You just leave it out to dry? Alright. That's the last time I spilled beer on a keyboard, that's what I did. And then it worked just fine when I plugged it back in. After I just let it dry. Isopropyl alcohol. I don't know, it seems like a lot of work. Like more work than I want to do. The rice method? Yeah. That also seems like a lot of work. considering that the last time this happened, I literally just tried out the keyboard and it worked fine. It seems like doing literally anything is a lot of work. I was open to the dishwasher suggestion, because that's like no extra work. That's about what I'm willing to do. That's the bar. How much extra work would you do for this? Zero. I will do zero more. Right now I have a keyboard that works. This one will probably work if I just plug it in again. Probably fine. Yeah, still sounds like a lot of work, Kane. Can I put the isopropyl alcohol into my dishwasher? Do they have, like, gel pads for that? I can see that working. Oh, thanks, Skyfy. Thanks for the kind offer. Yeah, pulling keys off. Pulling keys off is miserable. Some people really love digging around with technology, taking things apart, putting them back together and stuff. I'm not one of those people. My dad was one of those people. He was like always tinkering. What the fuck? This is kind of, that was like the most random card they could have played. My body's ready, my heart's on fire. I'm gonna push it over the wall. Alright, who had Hellspark Elemental on turn 9? You think they're a streamer with a sip? Maybe. I mean, it is possible that they're, like, an aggro deck. Because game one, they played out more aggro. So game two, like, they probably are still an aggro deck. They just had, like, a weird draw with, like, Detention Sphere, and it just, like, happened to play out slower than their average draw does. Marionette Master is definitely good. Definitely a good one. Just a lot of damage out of nowhere. Real versatile card. Mechanical keyboards are so loud. It depends. A lot of mechanical keyboards are loud, but you can get quiet switches. Right now I'm using Cherry Whites, which are like a little bit on the quiet side anyway, and then they've also wrapped them with sound dampeners.